The last minutes are ticking away in the presidential campaign. Nearly 100 million Americans have already voted. That's more than two-thirds of all the votes cast in 2016. Today offered a last chance to gin up tomorrow's turnout. White House correspondent Yamiche Alcindor reports.
The campaign's final day, and both candidates rushing to rally supporters, each in his own way. President Trump mounted a blitz, hopping across four states that helped deliver him the presidency in 2016, Wisconsin, Michigan, Pennsylvania, and North Carolina.
Remember what I said 4 years ago? I said, I am your voice, and we will make America great again.
Former Vice President Joe Biden focused his attention first on Ohio.
My message is simple. The power to change the country is in your hands.
But today, Pennsylvania is the one key state that got the most attention.
We're going to be covering a lot of ground today. Joe's going to be here, Jill's going to be here, Doug's going to be here.
Biden's running mate, Senator Kamala Harris, rallied residents in Luzerne County. It was an effort to flip back an area that last cycle helped hand the state to President Trump.
I think you all know, and that's why we're all here and keep coming back, because we care about Pennsylvania and because Pennsylvania is going to determine the outcome of this election.
The president also visited the county for a rally. He repeated claims that the nation would soon be rounding the corner on the pandemic.
You know, we've done such a great job with this whole thing. You look at Europe, they're spiking. We'll quickly eradicate the virus and wipe out the China plague once and for all.
In fact, the COVID crisis appears to be getting more dire as infections surge past 9 million. The top U.S. infection disease expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci, told the Washington Post over the weekend that the nation, quote, could not possibly be positioned more poorly as we head into the winter. The White House fired back in a statement to the Post, accusing Dr. Fauci of, quote, playing politics. Last night, in front of an enthusiastic crowd in Opa-locka, Florida, the president suggested Dr. Fauci may soon be fired.
Don't tell anybody, but let me wait till a little bit after the election, please. I appreciate the advice.
Today, Biden hammered the president's pandemic response at his own rally in Beaver County, Pennsylvania.
So he refuses to do the work to get this virus under control. He refused to do the work to get our schools and our small businesses the resources they needed to stay open. Firefighters, teachers, cops, a whole lot of hardworking folks.
Vice President Mike Pence, also in Pennsylvania, warned Biden's policies would be a drag on the economy.
Joe Biden's talking about shutting down the economy. Right at the time that we're beginning to get back on our feet as a country.
While the battle on the trail draws to a close, another fight over counting is brewing, with Pennsylvania also in the middle of it. The state's winner may not be decided by Tuesday night. In fact, some counties will not even begin counting ballots until the next day. Last night in North Carolina, President Trump criticized that delay, even though no state has ever reported complete final results on Election Day.
And I think it's terrible when we can't know the results of an election the night of the election in a modern-day age of computer decision.
He said he was already gearing up for a legal challenge.
We're going to go in the night of, as soon as that election's over, we're going in with our lawyers.
Today, Biden tried to assure people that their votes would be counted.
I don't care how much Donald Trump tries, there's nothing he's going to do to stop the people in this nation from voting. Folks, he hadn't figured it out. Presidents don't determine who gets to vote. Voters determine who's going to be the president.
Tensions on the ground are also building as the race wraps up. The FBI is investigating an incident in Texas last week where a convoy of Trump supporters in vehicles swarmed a Biden campaign bus on the highway. That led the campaign to cancel some events. President Trump later tweeted, quote, these patriots did nothing wrong. But business owners and officials throughout the country are bracing for the possibility of post-election violence, boarding up windows and erecting fences.
Also today, a federal judge in Texas refused to toss out nearly 127,000 ballots cast at drive-through polling centers in Houston. Republican activists had argued the practice was illegal. The judge ruled they had no legal standing to sue. Now we turn to Yamiche and to our Lisa Desjardins, both of whom following all of this very closely. Yamiche, to you first. We just heard some of what the president is saying on the trail. What is the thrust, the main thrust of his closing argument?
On this day before election, day, the president is focused on making a closing message that is focused on emotion more than policy. He's making the case that people should be more worried and more scared of the Black Lives Matter protests for racial justice and against police brutality than for the coronavirus pandemic that has killed more than 231,000 Americans and infected more than 9.3 million. He has said in rally after rally and state after state that we are rounding the corner. Of course, fake cases are spiking across the country. But the president says that he believes that this is the way forward, that he knows best, better than his infectious disease experts, including, of course, Dr. Anthony Fauci, who's attacked in different speeches. The president is also making the case, and campaign advisors told me today, that they feel confident that they are going to win in critical states, including Florida, Pennsylvania, North Carolina, states that the president won in 2016 and that surprised the political atmosphere in Washington. One other thing, the president is also making the case that if we don't know who is elected president by midnight tomorrow night, that the election somehow is rigged. That, of course, is not true. There's no evidence that there's any sort of voter fraud. In fact, in several elections, we have not known who was the president at midnight, including in 2016, in 2000, in 1976, and even in 1968.
And Lisa, Joe Biden, what is his closing message, and what do we know about the game plan here at the end?
You know, Vice President Biden had an interesting closing message today, as he's still campaigning as we speak. But one thing he said in ending a speech earlier today was, I will be the most pro-union president. He seems to be appealing to white working class voters that Democrats believe they lost in 2016, barnstorming across Pennsylvania. And the Biden campaign feels very good about this idea. They think they have many more paths to getting 270 electoral votes and the White House than does President Trump. They also like this, that the early vote count in many states seems to favor Democrats. If you look at registered voters who are submitting ballots in states that are announcing those numbers, they say they're ahead in Wisconsin, in Michigan, by amounts that mean that President Trump would have to win with 60% or more in order to carry those states. All signs of confidence for the Biden campaign. They also are saying something about those ideas of fear that Yamiche was talking about. The Biden campaign says the idea of election-related fear is in of itself suppression, and people need to be very aware that it may just be perception, not reality. They want people to go out and vote. They also say, by their math, there is no way that President Trump will be able to declare himself the winner by midnight on election night.
You know, two different stories coming out here. So, Yamiche, you've been following this president throughout his time in the White House. Tomorrow, last day of voting. What are you watching for?
Well, I'm watching for the same thing that the Trump campaign is watching for. They are bracing for both physical confrontations as well as legal confrontations. On the physical front, the president, as we noted in our tape, in our story, that the president is egging on in some ways his supporters who have physically been intimidating pro-Biden supporters. There are people on the campaign who say the president is okay to do that. I talked to someone today who was defending the president, saying these are people who did not break the law. It's fine to be able to walk up to people, to even drive up to people to intimidate them with your vehicle. So we should watch that space for more of that. Another thing to note is the president is actually already has automatic donations going all the way until mid-December. He's doing that because he wants to have money in the bank for a prolonged legal fight. The RNC has already put aside $20 million, Judy, to fight legal battles that they think that will happen soon after election. The president is also promising to have several lawsuits already filed tomorrow. So the president is already saying that in states like Pennsylvania and others, in North Carolina possibly, that he's already getting his lawyers ready to file something as early as tomorrow.
And we know both campaigns are gearing up, if necessary, for legal fights. Finally, Lisa, you are also very closely watching Senate and House races. What are you specifically looking out for tomorrow night?
Quickly, for the House, let's talk about that. Right now, speaking to Democrats and Republicans, no one is really talking about a likely path that Republicans have to taking back the House. In fact, there's more of a question of how many gains Democrats might make. Then let's look at the Senate. Let's look at where the Senate chamber is right now. Many people know 53 Republicans and then 47 Democrats and independents. Judy, I think that the situation is such that we have a dozen, perhaps, Senate races on the board. We may find out who will be president before we find out who controls the Senate.
All right, Lisa Desjardins, Yamiche Alcindor, you're both going to be busy tomorrow, as are we all. Thank you both.